about Asia. So I am Asia. I am the largest continent. I am covered with 1/3 of total land area of the earth. I am located near eastern hemisphere, near Tropic of Cancer passes through this continent. I am separated from Europe by the Ural Mountains on the west, and I am the landmass of the Europe called Eurasia. The word Asia means sunrise. This word comes from Greek. Thank you and have a nice day.
The second continent or the second largest continent is the Europe. Now we will coming to explain Europe.
Tell me.
Now Europe.
Me, sir.
Explain, Mr. Archer.
Yes, sir. Good morning, respected principal, sir, teacher, and all my dear friends. My name is Mohammed Arshad, and today I am going to explain some facts about Europe. I am Europe, and I am a continent located entirely in northern hemisphere and mostly in eastern hemisphere. I am also called Peninsula, Peninsulas, and Peninsula of Eurasia. Eurasia is the combined land area of Europe and Asia. In my continent, the largest country is Russia, 37% of total continent area. And my continent's smallest country is Vatican City, which occupies only a tiny territory in the center of Rome. In Europe, it includes 51 countries. Russia, Kazakhstan, Azerbaijan, Georgia, and Turkey are transcontinental countries partially located in both Europe and Asia. Important geographical facts about Europe. Europe is surrounded by water from all three sides. Arctic Ocean in the north, Antarctic Ocean in the south, Mediterranean Sea in the west, and Atlantic Ocean in the west. It is separated from Asia by Caspian Sea and Ural Mountains. Mount Elbrus is the highest peak of Europe. Important rivers of Europe: Danube, Dnieper, Don, Elbe, Loire, Oder, Po, Rhine, Rhone, Shannon, Tagus, and Volga are important rivers of Europe. Important plateaus of Europe: Iberian Plateau, Central Plateau of France, the Vosges and Black Forest, the Black Mountain of Germany, and Bohemian Plateau. Important mountain ranges of Europe: Carpathian, Apennines, Dinaric Alps, Carpathian are important mountain ranges of Europe. Important islands of Europe: Europe's largest islands and archipelagos include the Novaya Zemlya, the Franz Josef Islands, Svalbard, Iceland, the Faroe Islands, the British Isles, the Balearic Islands, Corsica, Sardinia, Sicily, Malta, Crete, and Cyprus. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Okay. Very well. So, as you know that Europe is much smaller than Asia, which lies in the west of the Asia. Now the third continent, which is the second largest continent after Asia, is Africa. And it is the only continent through which the Tropic of Cancer, Tropic of Capricorn, and the equator passes through. And it lies in the northern hemisphere, most of them, the rest of them in the southern hemisphere. Now, Abdul Rahman, Africa.
Assalamu alaikum. Good morning, respected principal, sir, teacher, and all my dear friends. My name is Abdul Rahman, and today I will be representing the world's second largest continent. Have you guessed who I am? Yes, you are right. I am Africa. I have 54 countries. The equator, 0 degrees, passes through the halfway of me. A large part of myself lies in the northern hemisphere. I am famous for the Sahara Desert and the world's longest river, the Nile River. Some facts about me are, I am the only continent through which Tropic of Cancer, Equator, and Tropic of Capricorn pass. Also, I am the world's hottest continent and the second driest continent. I am the second largest continent both in size and population. Thank you for giving me such a wonderful opportunity. Stay safe, stay healthy.
Then the third largest continent is the North America, and which is linked by South America through a narrow land or a narrow strip of land joining it with the landmass of South America known as isthmus. And this isthmus is known as the isthmus of Panama. So now we are coming to explain North America in short.
Yes, sir. My name is S. Prajesh. I am going to represent about explanation about North America. The North America is the third largest continent in the world. Population is more than 500 million people. And the area of the North America is 24.71 million kilometers squares. And in North America, there are 23 countries. And 9 dependencies with a total of more than 590 million people living on the continent. And the largest country on the North America is Canada. And the largest city is Mexico City, which is the capital city of Mexico, with a population of about 9 million. And this is the figure of North America. North America, and this is the flag. This is the flag of North America. And thank you. Have
now the fifth is the South America, which is joined by the isthmus of Panama through North America, which lies mostly in the southern hemisphere, little part is in the northern hemisphere, and which is surrounded by the oceans from the east and as well as the west. The Andes Mountain, which is the largest mountain in the world, is present here. The world's longest mountain range runs from north to south. Now who is coming to explain South America in short? South America short. Anyone can tell? And South America is also has the largest river with the name of Amazon present in this continent. Now the next continent is Australia. Who will be explaining Australia?
Anyone? Yes, sir. Good morning, respected principal, sir, teachers, and all my dear friends. I, Hitcha from Grade 6, is going to say something about Australia. Australia is the smallest continent that lies entirely in the southern hemisphere. It is surrounded on all sides by the oceans and seas, and thus it is also called as Iceland continent. Then Australia began its journey across the surface of the earth as an isolated continent between about 55 and 10 million years ago, and continues to move north by about 7 centimeters each year. Australia is the driest of any continent on Earth other than Antarctica. The Great Barrier Reef is regarded as the world's largest living organism and is often listed as one of the 7 wonders of the natural world, the Australia. Australia is the only continent covered by a single country. Thank you and have a nice day.
The last one, the 7th one is the Antarctica, which lies in the southern hemisphere, totally covered with snow. And South Pole is almost in the center of this continent. It is also known as the snow continent, where India is also established too, because it is a country where no one can have a permanent peace. only they can have temporary base there and they can have experiments they can do, they cannot live there permanently. So India has also established two stations there with the name of Dakshin Gangotri and Maitri. Who will be explaining in short Antarctica?
Sir, I can. Good morning, respected principal, sir, teacher, and all my dear friends. Myself, Anas Noor Muhammad.
Okay, let Anas Noor explain first. Then Rahman, you can explain. Anas Noor, explain.
Myself, Anas Noor Muhammad from class 6th B, 2. I'm going to explain on a small speech on a topic of Antarctica. Antarctica, completely in the southern hemisphere, is a huge continent. The South Pole lies almost at the center of this continent. As it is located in the South Polar region, it is permanently covered with thick ice sheets, and there are no permanent human settlements. Many countries have research stations in Antarctica. India also has three research stations there. They are named as Maitri and Dakshin Gangotri. Thank you.
Now, Lukman, explain in short.
Yes, sir. Good morning to everyone. Today, me, Lukman Ahmed Usman, is here to deliver a short speech on Antarctica.
Speak loudly, a little bit.
Yes, sir. I am the Earth's southmost continent. It is on the South Pole. It is almost entirely south of Antarctic Circle. Around me is the Southern Ocean. It is the fifth largest continent in area after Asia, Africa, North America, and South America. About 99% of me is covered by ice. This ice averages at least 1.6 kilometers thick. Antarctica is the coldest and driest and windiest continent. It is also, on average, the highest of all continents. Thank you and have a nice day.
Very good. Then the next topic is hydrosphere. As you all know, it is made up of a Greek word, name of Hydor. I have told you before also when the class started, which means water. And the sphere is the shape of the earth. That means the earth covered by water is known as hydrosphere. Now, Viraj Gandhi, explain in short, very short, about hydrosphere.
Good morning. Today, I, Viraj Gandhi, is going to represent as hydrosphere. So, hydrosphere is the water component of the earth. In simple words, I am all the water found in the earth. I cover almost 70.8% of the earth. And in 70.8% of the earth, I encompass all water bodies, icebergs, and as well as the water vapor. It also includes underground waters as aquifers and wells, a water fact. From in the earth, 69.9% is salt water, and only 1% is fresh water, and 20% is green land, and 10% is volcanoes. Now, you should think that why this much water is still there on the earth. This is happening because of the hydrological cycle. In this process, the water collects in the cloud, and then it falls on the earth as rain or snow. And this process continues. And because of this only, this much water is still on the earth. Thank you.
Now, there will be some question answers for you. Before that, about the oceans. As you know, five oceans are there: Pacific, Atlantic, Indian Ocean, Southern Ocean, and the Arctic Ocean. Because we have less time, we will read tomorrow about this oceans. So you will explain ocean tomorrow. Those who are going to explain ocean, they will be explaining ocean tomorrow. Now we will go for the question answer. some questions are asked, whatever you've read, and you have read about a little bit about ocean also, some questions from ocean also will be there. So you will answer one by one, raise your hand and answer it. Now the first question is coming to you. Which is the largest continent and how much it covers?
Sir, can I say?
Yes, sir.
Sir, the largest continent is Asia and it is covered with 1/3 of the total land area.
Very good. So, Asia is the largest continent which covers about 1/3 of the total area. Now, the second question coming, which mountain separates Asia from Europe?
Sir, can I say?
Yeah.
Sir, can I say?
Can I say? Sir, can I say?
That Hecha.
Sir, the Ural Mountains.
Very good. Now the next question, which is the only continent in the world through which Tropic of Cancer, Tropic of Capricorn and Equator?
Sir, can I
say?
Yes, sir.
Can I say?
Africa.
Yeah.
Sir, Africa.
It's say quickly. Which is the largest desert?
Sir, can I
say? Sir, can I say?
One by one, you raise your hand and then say, don't shout in between. No one will be able to listen. So the next question is coming to you. Which is the largest river in the world?
Can I say?
Yes, sir, Amazon.
Largest river.
Oh, largest.
Yeah. Amazon.
Amazon, yeah.
Sir, the participants, I'm not able to raise my hand.
Okay. By mistake, it was put Nile. It was. It should be longest river in the world. Now, which strip of land link North America to South America?
I know.
Yeah.
Then, Isthmus of Panama.
Yeah,
Isthmus of Panama.
Isthmus, you know what is Isthmus? I told you before.
Yes, sir, it's a narrow strip of land joining two land masses.
Yeah. Which continent is known as the island continent?
Australia.
Okay, can I say the answer?
Sir,
yeah.
Can I say the answer?
Yeah.
Australia.
Sir, by the ocean and seas.
Yeah.
Sir, I know. Can I say, sir?
Sir,
can I say?
Because...
Yeah. Okay, sir. Australia is called an island continent because water bodies cover it in the four sides.
Yeah. It is surrounded by ocean and seas from all the four sides. That's why it is known as Australian continent. What is the shape of the Atlantic Ocean? Anyone?
Can I say?
Yeah.
Can I say?
Yes, sir.
S shape.
S shape.
Very good. So.
This is
which country is named after
sir, Indian Ocean.
Very good. Indian Ocean is the country on whose name the Indian Ocean has been named after India.
Yes,
sir. Sir, remaining boys will do
tomorrow.
Okay.
Because time is not there. And I asked sir to say something to the boys. Sir, please.
Lesson is over.
Oh, 1 minute left. 2 minutes.
So, boys, did you enjoy the lesson? I think it was a very interesting lesson, and all of you participated. Huh? So, everyone has enjoyed, everyone has understood.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
It's good that all of you took part.
Some are remaining, they will do tomorrow the questions. Tomorrow they will be explaining questions.
I see. Do they know which is the deepest ocean?
Pacific Ocean, sir.
Yes, sir. The Pacific Ocean.